Sometimes the only thing that stands between a great time outdoors and a really, really shitty time is your ability to put a roof over your head. As a certified animal packer and former Marine Corps mountaineer, I know the value of a good knot. I'm Norseman, and this is What Not to Do. Now, if you don't know how to tie this ridge line, go ahead and follow the link in the card. If you already know, I'm gonna show you two knots that greatly increase your ability to build a roof with almost any material you have. We're gonna look at the prussic and the taut line hitch. So the first knot we're gonna look at is the prussic. Now this is a great knot that allows you to add and remove slack from your line with no pullback. Now the prussic line usually starts with an end cut. How long depends on the uses that you have for it. And you could have a double fisherman's knot or a single fisherman's knot. And the least desired way would be the European deaf knot because they have a tendency to capsize under great pressure. Now once you've got your loop tied with whatever knot you prefer, you want to offset that barrel a little bit so you have something to work with on the end. And then we're going to go one, two, three times. You can go four, but usually not necessary. Dress it up nice and clean. Once it's all clean, it's a very directional knot. You can't pull it either way, but you can slide it relatively easy along the line if you hold pressure on the knot. So we'll slide it down here. So with my tarp, I'll just put a toggle in here, and then I can pull this tight. And it won't pull back unless I want to, and then I can just slide the knot back. Now the messier you leave this, the harder it's going to be. It can lock up and be really difficult to move, but if you keep it dressed up really nice at the beginning, then you can, it doesn't matter how tight you get it, you'll always be able to slide it pretty easy. And it will not slide on its own. So let's do a little prussic test. Obviously, it's dressed up nice, slides really easy, binds up that way, binds up this way, no problem. Let's see how strong that bind is. This is not a giant stick, but it's pretty substantial. It's at least as substantial as the eyelet on a tarp. Pretty sure that didn't move an inch. All day, every day. Now here's another prussic that might be a little easier to remember. Find the direction where you want it to pull. Wrap your line one, two, three times. Now take the direction, feed it back through that loop, and draw it tight. It's not as clean, and usually the messier this is, the tighter it holds, but it's a lot easier to tie, generally easier to remember in a pinch. The prussic is one of those knots that's almost magic when you use it in the outdoor. There's a whole bunch of different variations from French prussic to Clem Heist to a Texas kick, used for various different reasons where you can maintain, where you can use that friction to essentially not move or to move directionally however you want. Look them up. I'm sure that there's a lot more different types and ways to tie a prussic, but I think once you get used to using just the simple bi-directional prussic knot, then you'll find a million uses for it and a whole bunch of different variations. Now we're going to take a look at how to secure our tent pegs while maintaining a little bit of adjustment in them. We're going to look at the midshipman's hitch and the taut line hitch. So now I'm going to use this climbing rope to illustrate this knot, but generally this isn't the best stuff. It doesn't hold really, really good on this unless it's got a lot of tension holding on it. But for tent ropes, for 550 cord and the like, it's just easier to demonstrate with a larger rope. So we'll say that this line goes to my tent and this one goes around my peg. I'm going to come over this line and go one, two. So now that I have those two passes, I want to go over this one where it crosses over the top, back around and through. Let me dress that up and you can see what it's supposed to look like. So this big line doesn't hold very well, but that's what we're going for. Something that looks like that. And that's the taut line hitch. and it'll allow you to slide it up and down the line, and then the tension will bite into the line and lock it. So let's see it in action on a piece of 550 cord. I'm gonna go around the peg. I'm gonna come up and I'm gonna go 1, 2, and I'm gonna cross over it, come around the other side and back. Ideally, it should form a cross. If both of these pieces are coming out the same side, it won't hold. Then you just tighten the line and it'll bite and hold. Idea for tarps, tents. A lot of times when you buy a tent, it'll come with a little plastic buckle that locks and toggles, and those things break pretty quick. Usually your first or second time out, and then you have to come up with something like this, or you have to play the game where you're constantly pulling and replacing tent pegs in order to get the tension correct. This way, after maybe a exceptionally windy night, you come out in the morning and your tarp's a little bit loose and floppy, all you have to do is put a little slack, slide and lock, tighten everything back up, and you're good to go for another day. If you want to do a different version of that, essentially the same, that goes to my tent, this goes around my peg. I'm gonna do almost the same. I'm gonna come on the inside, under, around. Now, instead of just going over, I'm gonna come back through itself, like that. Then I'm gonna go over, a little more slack here. Then I'm gonna go over this and back through itself. Performs the exact same function. Again, it doesn't work very well in climbing rope, but it performs the function very well on 550 for your guy lines. Give myself a little more slack. And now I'm gonna come over. I'm gonna go under once, around again, back under here and out. See? Instead of going here, I'm gonna go under here and out. It's gonna cross over, and then it's gonna come back out the opposite side. So when the knot is tied, it looks like a T. Incorrectly, on both of them, would look like that. So if you get that, you're mostly there. Just take that out, move it to the other side, and go back through. There we go. Hook that over the peg. Now I can bring it up tight, and it'll hold. And that's the midshipman's hitch. I hope you get a lot of use out of the Prusix, and then the taut line hitch and the midshipman's hitch. If you use those when you're camping, you're gonna look like a professional in any company. If you like that or you got anything out of it, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Once again, if you wanna see this ridge line, I'll go ahead and put that link right here. I hope you enjoyed that. Go ahead and subscribe and ring that bear bell, and I'll see you on the trail.